once again. On a day when the government was shut down in Washington, I think we've done pretty well staying the whole day. So what I'll do, just take about 1, 2 to 3 minutes, very quickly give you the key takeaways that we have had from different sessions. We started off the day by saying that Bangladesh is a key relevant player in the international system. It's a major US ally in the region. It's a country that is 6th or 7th largest nation in the world, the 3rd largest Muslim country. So it's a major player in the international system, and the international community, including the United States, needs to pay key attention to that area. We also said that it is located in a space which is of a high value strategic location, located between India and China, and it's a country that has growing cooperation both politically and militarily with the United States. The first session talked about the growing political uncertainties over the coming elections in Bangladesh and the possible ramifications. The critical question is about the conduct of the elections, how it will be conducted, the ground rules of conducting the elections. And it was pointed out that the basic thing to have would be to have a level playing field where all parties could agree to have an all-inclusive election, and which is an election based on fair play. It was also pointed out that political impasse and confrontational politics can very quickly go out of control. And that is a message I would like you to take home. If we don't have an inclusive election on time, things can very easily go out of control, and violence can have unknown uncertainties and consequences. We also said that solution is possible, either within the constitution or beyond the constitution, if there is a political will. It is also important to say that there is increased human rights violation happening in Bangladesh, and the space for civil society and free speech is gradually being squeezed. We saw the reports of the Human Rights Watch, which say that the extrajudicial killing or killing in custody is becoming a regular practice in Bangladesh, and that has to go away. In the next session, we talked about the threat of growing radicalization and terrorism in Bangladesh, and it was pointed out that the threat is real and the threat is growing. The threat landscape in Bangladesh on the issue of radicalization and terrorism is growing and is becoming complex because of the regional linkages that it has. A special note was made about the post-2014 Afghanistan and the possible spillover effects that it can have in the region, including Bangladesh. A detailed account was given of the response by the two major political parties in Bangladesh in responding to the threat of terrorism, and it was pointed out that in the period between 2001 to 2007, the Deen government that was in power by the BNP enacted a number of laws and enacted a number of critical decisions that were given in facing the challenges of terrorism, and the same commitment was shown by the next government, which is the current ruling government, in continuing the present city efforts in that country. We talked about new trends of urban radicalization, female radicalization, web-induced radicalization, and the new trends of splinter groups in Bangladesh. And an emphasis was made that any kind of counter-terrorism efforts by the government has to be depoliticized. The current trend by the government to accuse the opposition for issues of sponsoring terrorism has to stop, and we should take counter-terrorism measures above politics. We talked about, in the next session, about an emerging economy in Bangladesh that has the potential of growing into something much better and much bigger. And we said that there is a sustained growth in the country of 6% and above. A spirit of entrepreneurship that is available in the country is the engine of growth for the future. It was pointed out that the problem of corruption in Bangladesh is a major corruption, and that is eating away into the potential of the country, including its GDP potentials. A survey of the trade landscape was taken, and it was said that Bangladesh is increasingly growing its trade relationship with all countries, including the United States. The question of ready-made garments export to United States market and the current problem of GSP was also highlighted. We also talked about equilibrium of economic relationship at five different levels and why it was important to achieve that level. It was pointed out that the labor standard problem in Bangladesh is an issue, and although it has not been adequately addressed, but the political parties, including the opposition, shows commitment to improving the labor standards in the country, including issues of child labor. It was pointed out that institutional capacity growth in terms of economics and trade is an essential element of Bangladesh. Speakers pointed out that the state-run economy that was included in Bangladesh in post-70 was then led to an investment-friendly capitalist form of economy in Bangladesh in the post-75 period, and the BNP, the opposition party, is committed to an investment-friendly climate that it can ensure if it goes to power. It also said that it will also include energy investment and welcome all sorts of energy investment by other countries. The issue of Grameen Bank and Dr. Yunus and women empowerment was pointed out, and it was also said that Nobel laureate Dr. Yunus is being harassed currently, is being abused at many levels, and that needs to stop. Regional cooperation was pointed out in the last session, and it was pointed out that India's attitude of bilateral approaches to solving all problems needs to have multilateral approaches in many cases, so that the asymmetry that it has in the region is managed better. The role of India and China came up for discussion. The issue of environmental challenges that faces Bangladesh came up for discussion, and India's attitude towards Bangladesh in many of its bilateral relations was pointed out, and it was said that we need a brother, not a big brother. So the issue of border killings in Bangladesh border came up for discussion, and according to some writings that you see, it is called the new killing fields, because every year over 100 Bangladeshis are killed by Indian border guards, and the statistics by Human Rights Watch is that from 2001 to 2010, over 1,300 Bangladeshis have been killed by Indian border guards. Bangladesh's role as a maritime nation was pointed out, and the issues of the deep sea port in Chittagong, which has tremendous strategic importance and economic potential, was pointed out, and the interest of China in that port was also discussed. We also talked about the so-called string of pearls. It was also pointed out that there is increased disaster cooperation between Bangladesh and United States and the international community. The issue of water security of Bangladesh and Tipaimukh Dam came up for discussion, and the issue of transit and the lack of infrastructure in Bangladesh in implementing the Indian strategy of transit or the so-called corridor came up for discussion and debate. The threat of climate change is a major issue for Bangladesh. It is not only an issue, it is an existential issue for Bangladesh. So that is a critical threat to Bangladesh's existence and security. The problem of migration was pointed out by the speakers, and it was also pointed out that Bangladesh currently does not have an implementable plan for relocating its people. I would like to say here that the government's NAPA and the government's country strategy paper speaks about a 25 to 30 million climate refugees happening due to sea level rise and other climate-induced conditions. So for a country as small as Bangladesh, it is absolutely physically impossible to relocate these people. When there's a question of relocation of 30 million people, there has to be a regional and an international arrangement to relocate people. But we are seeing the gradual movement of IDPs, or internally displaced persons, and I would also say due to the disasters of various cyclones that has happened in Bangladesh over the years, these IDPs have become permanently displaced persons, or what I call them PDPs. There's a stream of people streaking into Dhaka every single day due to climate-induced conditions and river bank erosion, and Bangladesh faces tremendous threat from the challenges of global warming and climate change, and it's an issue that faces Bangladesh's existence. I would once again like to thank all of you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us today, the whole day. It is not very often that you discuss about Bangladesh in Washington, D.C., and that for a whole day. and especially on a day when the government is shut down. So I would once again like to say that let us keep engaged in Bangladesh, because Bangladesh faces some grave uncertainties that could have repercussions not only for the country, but for the region and for the international security and community. So therefore, let's keep our focus on Bangladesh so that we continue to engage each other, so that Bangladesh moves ahead in its path of democracy and maintains the stability which is sought after by all Bangladeshis and our friends in the international community. Once again, a very warm thanks to all of you for being here with us today.
General, thank you very much. That's a wonderful summary, so I'm not going to add any more to that, but I will put a point on this. We've run one or two events a week since I've been here the last 2 years. Never have I seen more people show up than RSVP to show up. And that happened consistently all day today. And rarely, in fact, this is the first time I can remember us putting on a 5 or 6 hour event in a single day, and you all hung with us. So I hope you weren't all furloughed and came here. But as you know, we did have three of our speakers were furloughed. And I think it's a real credit to our panel and to those who were here who very easily slid into this, and they were all expert and they all did just such a wonderful job. And I thank the Bangladesh Institute for Peace and Security Studies and what you've done here. And I think there is an intense interest in Bangladesh more than you would realize here in Washington, D.C. in the United States. And we want to fan that flame, and I think we've done that very well today. And for that, I thank our panelists, and I thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.